how can we make our Zoom sessions more engaging so that when we do our training, we've got our students more involved? In this video, I'm going to show you two great techniques. I'm going to connect to three technologies that can really add a lot of variety to the way that we deliver in Zoom. Really hope you like the video, and as always, if you do, please like it, please share it, and I'd love to know in the comments which of the techniques did you like the best. Let's get started. So we're going to start with a really fabulous technology called AnswerGarden, and this is brilliant for quickly getting all your students to share their ideas together in one place. Obviously, we can use the chat window, but that just comes up individually. The idea with this is that super quickly we get a cloud, and there really isn't a faster cloud technology. Let me just show you. I'm going to click here. And I'm going to ask a question to my students. The question I'm going to ask them is, what do you like about learning languages? Okay, so really simple question. I'm having a discussion, I'm doing a language lesson with my students, and I want to ask that question. So I just write the question in AnswerGarden. I'll change it to 40 characters so they can write a longer answer. And then all I need to do is click on create. Now, in the Zoom session, all I do now is share that link. So the students click on the link and then they can answer the question. So just share that link straight away, and any student, for example, I like meeting new people, and immediately they press enter, that answer will appear on the screen. So let's just do another one. For example, I like learning about cultures, and so another student writes in another answer, and bang, we get all those answers together. So immediately we get all these different answers together. Now, I frequently use this as a tool to quickly get students' answers together, and obviously what we can do afterwards is screen share it in Zoom. So you can see here an example of a AnswerGarden, just really quick way of collecting together everyone's thoughts or everyone's ideas. Now, you don't only have to be limited to just one, you know, a single word. You could get the students to actually write sentences as well, but it's just a great way of collecting together all the students' ideas in one place. So you can see I've shared the link in the Zoom window, so all the students would need to do is click on that link, and then they can write their answer. So they can put their answer, I love languages, let's say. Okay, and all the answers are coming together now. I'm just going to jump back to Zoom. What we can do once the students have answered the question, and if we're in the Zoom session ourselves as a teacher, and we want to see how are they doing, how are they writing, all we need to do is click here underneath and jump to the AnswerGarden. We're not screen sharing, so we can just check, okay, great, the students are writing up their answers. Come back to Zoom. And when we're ready, we just simply click on screen share, and then we can share all the answers. So, right, guys, let's see what you've been writing. Now, I do this all the time. It's a great way of collecting together all the answers of the students in one place. If you want to learn more about using AnswerGarden, there's a video now that on the screen that you can click on and link. I'm now going to shift over to another technology that I love, that I use a lot, and that's Mentimeter. And Mentimeter is great because it's another activity that gets the students engaged. And I use this a lot when I want students to kind of choose between options. So I've presented something and I want to say, okay, I want you now to vote on the thing that you like the best, or the comment on the thing you like the best, or rank the thing you like the best. Again, I share the link, the students click on it, so they're doing something different, a bit more variety. And then again, once they finished, I can open it up on the screen and we can see what all of the class have written or have shared or have voted on. So let's just see how Mentimeter works. So we're on the homepage of Mentimeter. I'm going to click on new presentation. This is a free tool, and I'm going to call this one ranking activity. Okay. And I'm going to click on present presentation. Now, the brilliant thing about Mentimeter is that you've got loads of different activities that you can do with the students. So you could give them a multiple choice question, or you can actually give them up to three questions, or get them to do a word cloud activity, rather similar to AnswerGarden, but it's not as quick to set up, so I prefer to use AnswerGarden, or an open-ended discussion, or they can scale something, and I really like this one, I use it a lot. And our ranking works really well if you want, say, for example, the students to vote on something. Maybe you've presented a a series of things and say, okay, which one do you like the best, or which one are you most interested in, or what topic should we be discussing today, or what feature of this particular technology do you like the best? So loads of different activities, Q&A, type an answer, select an answer. What I'm going to do the first one is scale, because I like this quite a lot, and it's so easy to make an activity. So what I'm going to ask them, for example, in this one is, what tools, or rank these tools, let's just put that in there, rank these tech tools. So I'm going to get students to, or teachers in my case, because I teach teachers and training organizations, I'm going to write Zoom, Microsoft Teams. I'm just going to get them to vote on perhaps which is their, let's say, favorite technology. So I'm going to perhaps Moodle. I'm just doing a really quick example here to show you what I mean. Let's just do a couple more. Let's put in Blue Button. And perhaps we'll end with putting in Edmodo. Okay, so we give them a choice of different technologies, and we want them to rank these technologies. Now, let's imagine that I've already presented these technologies to the students or to the teachers. Now, once I've written out the question, you can see how quick it is to do the question. All I do is click on the share button, and then I can share this link, copy link. So if I was in a Zoom session, I would simply come back to my Zoom session and share the link. And then the students can click and then do the activity. Now, I'm going to quickly show you what the activity looks like, just so you get a feeling. But the brilliant thing is that all that data is instantly coming back to me. So when I share the link, what I actually do is I then screen share the Mentimeter, because as the answers appear, this will change. And you can actually put it in present mode. So as the answers come onto the screen, you'll see that suddenly it will go 5 or 6 or whatever, depending on all the answers that the students write. And it will also tell you how many people have voted. So it's brilliant to use live and to share the answers on the screen, that which then you can discuss afterwards. So let's actually look at what the student does. So when the students click on the link that you've shared in Zoom, this is what they see, and they simply vote. So they can add up whatever they think, okay? And they can, now we can change the score. For example, if we want to have it more than 5 points, we just simply put our votes on our favorite technologies. We click on submit. Now, if I jump back to the teacher's view, you'll notice that those answers have been immediately added in to the view that the teacher gets. There we are, we can see the data, and as other people vote, the data will change. So everything is live, and it's a great technology to use. Obviously, what you want to do is screen share this, so that once the students have voted, they can see what is happening on the screen and who's voting. Now, just a couple of tips when you're working with this technology. For example, you can change the scale. You can have, say, from 1 to 10, and you can change the comments. So, for example, I might have don't like, okay, right up to love. Okay, so you can choose the type of ranking you want, depending obviously on what you present. Just a really quick break from the video, just to promote my website. If you like the video on Zoom and you want more videos, come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. There's a special section on teaching online and a special section on Zoom. Some of my Zoom videos have been played more than 500,000 times. If you want to follow my work, then sign up to the newsletter. That way you get updated with all the latest videos, the blogs, the webinars that I run, some of them for free, and also, of course, any online courses I run. And at the moment, if you sign up, there's a 12-part series for free on how to teach online. Thanks. Let's get back to the video. If you want to know more about working with Mentimeter, there's a link on the screen now that you can click on and learn some of the advanced features. But what I'm going to do now is show you another technology I use. And this one's different, the work with Google Jamboard. Let me take you through some techniques that you can use with Google Jamboard that can really make your sessions much more engaging. So Google Jamboard is a free technology as long as you have a Gmail account. I'm going to click here to go to my Jamboards. It's a technology that I've been starting to use more and more, simply because it's so quick and easy to use. If I just click down here on New Jamboard, the idea that Jamboards are kind of like interactive whiteboards or electronic corkboards, and students can add up all their ideas onto the screen. Now, there's one thing that we need to do before we start. Normally we write up the question, so we click here and I'm going to say the question is, what is your favorite technology. So again, this is a great way of getting students to interact together and suggest ideas. Now, there's a couple of nice features of the way that it works. So the first thing you have to do is click on Share and change it so that all the students can access the Jamboard and add their ideas. And to do that, you need to come down to here, switch this, and change it from anyone with the link can view to anyone with the link can edit. That is the key button. Then you copy the link, and that is what you would share in your Zoom session. So back in Zoom, I would then share that link so that the students could then therefore click on the Jamboard and simply begin to interact with it. So any student could now click on that and it opens up the Jamboard and they can begin to add up their ideas. Now, the interesting thing is that they can do a lot more than we can do, for example, with AnswerGarden. And I'm going to just show you some of the things that the students can do. So let's imagine that I'm on Jamboard and I want to add a comment. One of the nice things I can do is write a sticky note. So I click on here and I'm going to say, I really like working with WordWall. It's a technology that I make a lot of use of. Now notice straight away that you can write a lot. You're not restricted to just a few words, so it's much richer. You can also choose a different color so that we can have a bit of variety and the different ideas stick out. And often I ask the person to write their name afterwards so I know who wrote that contribution. Okay, first sticky is up on the screen. Now if another student logs in, and let's just do that, so I can see now that someone's already written on the screen and I can add my idea. So I can click here and say, this is my idea. So this is the second student now adding up their idea. Now, and then they would add that. Now notice that the sticky notes all sit one on top of the other. Now this is actually quite interesting because when the teacher then goes to screen share, and let's now jump back to Zoom. So when the teacher screen shares, what they can do now, if they screen share the screen, is the teacher can say, right, let's look at the ideas. So first one, talk about that or maybe comment on it and then perhaps delete it and then bring the next one into the middle and then talk about that one, etc. But we're not limited when we work with Jamboard in this way. We can add text, so we can click here and just mark on the screen and start to write. So we can add text this way as well. So students can do, as I said, sticky notes. The sticky notes sit on top of each other. They can also add text. Now, the other great thing is that you can extend this. So, for example, you could say, if you was in a class, you could have more than one page. And one thing you can do, for example, let's say you've got five groups working. So then you can have in the breakout rooms, group one, group two, group three, group four, group five, and each group would have a page where they would add their ideas. Now, what you can do as well is even name the pages, but you don't really need to do that because it does tell the students at the top of the page which page number they're on. One simple tip, if you're going to do this, make sure that you share the link to the Google Jamboard before the students move into breakout rooms. So put them, share the link in the chat window, and then they can move into breakout rooms, and then one person in each group can open up, go to the correct page, and then add their content. Remember to click on the share button. Make sure that you, when you share the link in the chat window before you put the students into breakout rooms, that you have got it set to can edit. Really important, otherwise the students can't actually write into the Jamboard. Love to know which of those ideas you like the best. Please write your ideas in the comment section. If you want more free videos, please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. There's a special section on Zoom that you might find really useful, and a special section on teaching online. Don't forget, if you'd like to follow my work, the best thing to do is to sign up to the newsletter. And if you sign up at the moment, there's a free 12-part video series about using technology to teach online. And of course, you get updated with all the latest videos and the blogs and the webinars and all the online courses that I run. Of course, the other thing that you can do to follow me is to follow me on YouTube, join my channel. Don't forget to click on the bell so that you get all the updates. And the final thing is, if you are interested me doing some training for your organization or a conference presentation workshop, then you can contact me from the website. Finally, on the screen now, there are some more videos about working with Zoom that you might find really useful. And thank you very much.